This will be setting up your base, the movie. So first thing we're going to do is ditch these shitty old strings. And sometimes I keep them. Most times I don't. They just got other people's crap all over them. Thing is, if you're going to do a setup, the reason you want to have new strings is because, especially on a bass, the strings get all dented and marked, and it affects how things intonate on the frets. Watch this. This is the quick way to take the strings off. That's one of the reasons why I'm not keeping them, because I don't want to thread all this bullshit back through the bridge. I don't know, I'm sure I should be recycling this. So, yep, we're gonna go for the movie. It'll be the movie version. Okay. Next, I'm gonna take. I gotta hot up my compressor. I gotta pause. It's just gonna go for like 5 minutes. Okay, so. This is your chance to clean all the shit off your bridge. And what I do is do the toothbrush method. Oh, look at that. Isn't that just frickin' grimy? And then the old airline. And we'll capture most of that in the rag. Whoa, that's just frickin' shiny as ever. Gotta love that. Then another trick I like to use is drag your hag right underneath all the bridge saddles. Takes a little bit of coax in there. Come on. Now, if it's really frickin' screwed up, like if there's like so much crap in there that this doesn't work, what you can do is take the whole thing right apart. Okay, we got that sussed. And those are all right side up again. And we're good to go. Oh. Next. Now's my chance to clean up my fretboard. Everybody wants to know, where do you get the brush, the surgical brush? It's Lee Valley Tools. L-E-E Valley Tools. And you can see there's like quite a bit of shit on there. And I might go at it one more time. There's that much, especially down in the money zone. There's no money up here if you're playing for a living. Most of the money's down at this end. That's what I know. Frets on this are sort of dented. I don't think the guy wants to pay for fret work. In fact, I know he doesn't want to pay for fret work, so we're just going to set it up with the new strings best we can. That's gonna be that. Okay, what's left to do now? Gonna clean the frets with the old Never Dull. See what's going on with that. If there's really lots of crud on the frets, I'll show you the other trick. Right now, there's that. Oh geez, this thing and 1000 grit gets off, you know, you got some serious tarnish action. Yeah, this guy's been played, so there was some story about the guy buying it and putting it under a bed. Well, I don't think the frets got all mushed like that when it was under a bed. So, whatever the guy told him, the story was bullshit. And he didn't know enough when he was buying it to look to see if the frets had wear on them or not, if they were dented or marked by the strings. So I don't know, apparently this is some old ancient Yamaha thing that should be relished and ketchuped and mustarded all simultaneously. It's a neck through. I hate neck throughs. I shouldn't say I hate them, I just don't trust them. They tend to want to curl up here where the truss rod ends. And, to me, if you're going to do the neck through, why does the truss rod stop there? Why doesn't it just go, why doesn't it go all the way through? I don't know. Zooming out. Oh, look at that. Okay, back to the professional setup aspect of things. Change the bass strings. Time me. Go. Now. Okay. Somebody's going, yeah, the hourly rate and the setup rate. And that's okay, like I said, I'm going to put new strings on this now. Time me. Oh, and I forgot to check the radius when I was stringless. It's a 10. So now we're going to, this is the electronic check, right? So, that's a lack of use. But, you know, sounds like I need to blow some cleaner in there and do that part of it. Let's tune it to pitch. Check the neck straightness again. Turn down the hum maker. I'm way over here. And it's looking pretty good. So let's dump the string action and set that up. I don't know, I gotta look at this again. See, neck through crap. It's the same sort of crap that happens on an acoustic guitar. Where the neck is glued to the body, we get all kinds of weirdness happening here where things all join together. So I can sort of see where this one's going. I gotta see if I can straighten this out a little more. But see, the truss rod stopped really working here and everything's sort of lifting there. Okay, so once again, oh no, I put it away. Okay, you're not going to get in there with anything but this wrench. They didn't tell you that back in school. This thing's really tight too, so Yeah, we're going to look at it from a different angle. I know this is just like so interesting. Different light, different angle compared to the strings. That's very straight. That's the way I like to start. Let's dump the strings. Where's that other little screwy driver? There she is. Once again, this is one of those. Cut. If you ain't got the right one, you're gooched. That's what I know. There we go. So we'll dump this down. Oh, I hate the, oh no, uh-oh. Gouged, frozen up stuff. We didn't quote that in, did we? In the setup, that all your hardware is gonna be all rusted to shit. Alrighty, so I got the string action set for the G and the E to where I like it, which is approximately 0.060 at the 12th fret. Now we're going to match the old radius, which is just right gooched. Like, come on, not more frozen stuff. That looks a little more realistic. The A string needs to just come up a hair. Oh, I hate these. Okay, so do we know the name of the person who invented the slotted drive? Like, do we ever find out who that guy actually was? Can we, like, you know, can we Google that and definitely have him looked for? Okay. I can dig that. Let's check some intonation. Once again, G string, flat, that means too long, must let the bridge settle out. Where's that hidden? I'm so sure you're seeing the back of my melon at this point. Then I'll get to check all this again in the playing position. Are you getting a good shot of the back of my head there? Come on. Of course, they've got that hidden in there. Really well. I like that. Once again, a little flat as well. Loving it. Okay, now that it's set up right, the pickup heights are too close to the strings. So we'll fix that. Uh-oh, I didn't like the way that felt. Yeah, it's about now when, you know, all the hardware holding the pickups in place falls off inside the guitar. So, left there by the last guy who adjusted everything to its limit in the wrong direction. There, that's Nicer, more nicer. Okay. More? More? Is there more? I mean, that does look nice. Really does. Oh. Sorry, I'm dog fucking again. What am I checking next? Oh. Nut action here. Usually, if nobody's dicked with it, it's fine. If someone has dicked with it, then we're into a whole other job of repairing the nut or cutting a new nut. Back to what I, like I said, should have marked this gauge last time. See, I'm wasting time again. 20 thou. Can you see me way down here? Oh, here comes the noisemaker. 20 thou, plus or minus 2 thou. So that's on the low side, because that's 20. So let's just see how low that is. So this is a cool little trick, right? For the nut action. So if you got your feeler gauge, so what have I got? I don't know. 20 thou. So this is neat. So if you just sort of pull the string, right, and you ride that in on top of the fret, you see I stopped the string from vibrating. So it's less than 20. Let's see, what have I got here? There's 12. Let's see. No, that ain't 12. That's 12 stacked with frickin' 10, there's 22, you dummy. No, that's 12. See? That one slides in, doesn't stop the string, so it's more than 12. I think I measured it at 13, which is really low. And that might have to do with the string gauge choice, but it seems to be riding quite high. Like, it's not sitting too low in the nut. So maybe that's just the way she is. Seems to play okay. What's the last step in this process? Gotta re-jig the camera here. Go roll with me here on this one while I zoom in. So it's got, is that where that little boo-boo is? Right there? Yeah. So free of charge. I'm gonna put a little tick of lacquer in that for the guy, because that's what we do. So there's your setup. Oh, right, I still gotta spray out the electronics. See, I'm right out of the movie now. Ah! Okay. So now, after I let it all settle down for a bit, we got the capo on it. I released the truss rod a bit. We're going to check to see if there's some relief. I'm seeing like probably 12 or 13 thou, which is 10, 11. Let's just see. I think it's beautiful. Cheers. Oh, you guys missed this too. Like, I had to tighten up the output jack. And after I added relief to the neck, guess what had to happen? We had to drop the string action. Because it's a neck through. And as soon as I released the truss rod, it did a really weird dance. Dance of the neck through bass. Give with noise. There we go. So once again. doorbell's not working. Oh, it's here. It doesn't work so good today. What's going on? Well, I'm going to drag both of these upstairs for a demo just because we can. Holy smokes! Yamaha, does that say BB 1200? Cool.